Real quick vibe check on Bol Bol.
You all, you just cannot not. You just can't not talk
it's
about
what
Bol
the people
Bol.
want.
You
it's what
can't
the people
not
want.
Talk about
it gets well, the people going.
Bol, like you just cannot resist talking about Bol Bol. The answer is no, by the way.
Can Bol Bol help the Suns in this series?
Okay, let me take that back. The answer is, can he? Sure. Will he? No. I think.
Why? Because he won't play? Or
yes,
even if he got
yes,
in there, he
wouldn't? Yes, yes, yes. If he got in, I don't think he would make the biggest impact. You know, I think his size would afford him to get rebounds. His ability to make shots from the corner and from three will also help out a little bit. His underrated ability to drive and make floaters, in my opinion, could also help as well, especially with that size. I just don't think he's going to get in with the way Frank has been coaching and doing his rotations at all. So that's why I say no, just because Frank Vogel seems to be stuck in the 8-man rotation. He seems to be with now Grayson Allen out. Who knows where he's going to go? Maybe he just goes 7 and just continues to be stubborn. I have no clue. Bol Bol's not going to play. That's just, I hope I'm wrong. And I'm knocking on wood for that. And I just hope that I'm wrong, but I just don't think he's going to play. I think Frank has his rotation. He's stuck on it. Stubborn on it, not going to happen.
Great points. I don't want to disagree. I just feel like Frank's going to get desperate pretty soon here. You know, the calls for Bol Bol are not going to stop. And once you get to the point where you're being taken to the brink and you can tell it's damn near over, I think he's going to reach deep into that bag and call Bol Bol's name. And he's going to call Thad Young's name just so that he can say in the end, I tried everything.
I tried everything.
I tried. I put them all in there. But it's like, bro, you also froze him out the last 10 games of the season and then didn't play him in the first two. And so who knows what kind of Bol Bol you're going to get when he does come out there. Now, the biggest thing with Bol Bol that people say that has some legitimacy is he's going to get shoved around. He's going to get moved around. That is possible. I have long felt like he's going to outweigh the bad with good, aka open threes, a nifty blocked shot here or there, some cheeky offensive rebounds that give you second chances. And I might have said this already, but threes, so another guy who can hit threes.
So as you were talking, I was just thinking about the way the Timberwolves, and this is just a theory, the way the Timberwolves are guarding the Suns, and thinking about the potential mismatch in size. So the issue is Gobert, Nurkic, Durant. We're starting Beal, Grayson, but now it's going to be Royce, I think. Booker, Durant, Nurk. I have a theory, like what happens if, let's just say we take out Royce or whoever, put Bol Bol in. The way they're guarding is McDaniels on Durant or whoever, Ant on the main ball handler, and Cat's going to be guarding the third guy. That leaves someone small guarding Bol Bol. That makes a major mismatch. That means a Mike Conley would be left having to guard Bol Bol. That's a size advantage. That now that you've said it, I do think that is a way to go. That's a way to think and innovate and say, hey, Bol Bol, Kevin Durant's playing the three, you're playing the four. The way they've been guarding us, they're leaving Mike Conley on our other rotational player. You have a major size advantage. And if it forces Mike Conley to then guard your ball handler or guard someone else, then I think that works out for you. Just a thought. I think that that's something possible that I would consider if I was Frank Vogel. I just don't know if he will, but I do think that that is one potential advantage, is giving you size against a quote unquote somebody you're trying to hide on defense.
Yeah, I think that's a great point. The other thing I would mention with Bol Bol, we need the Suns fans to show up and compete against the Timberwolves fans the way that the Timberwolves home court has been so strong. The Suns fans need to go in there and be the same way. What better way to light the crowd up and get a return of transferred energy from Bol Bol into the crowd, back into the team? It's happened all season. This isn't crazy talk. This isn't some thing I'm just pulling out of thin air. I've seen it so many times, Sundo. I've seen Bol Bol come in, the crowd stand up, put their hot dogs and drinks down, and just start cheering. And that sort of energy gets transferred into the team, and we go on runs. And yeah, so I really do think he can help.
I kind of, I'm the more I'm thinking about it, and yes, because I think I came up with it, right? I think it's my idea.
No, it's all your idea.
But all jokes aside, like the more I think about it, you putting Bobo in and leaving Durant in, and you have Nurkic, Bobo, and Durant all legitimately seven footers at some point, it will force those other rotational players that you want to hide onto Bobo. And that does create a major mismatch. As I know Mike Conley is a veteran, but there's just so much size there. I don't think that Conley would be able to handle it. Who's the other rotation player that we saw? Was it Morris that we saw?
Nikhil Alexander Walker just crushed.
Alexander Walker would definitely be guarding, you know, one of your big three. That's just the way they utilized him, right? But always that rotation player that had to be hidden. You put Bobo on there. I just think that's a major thing to look at. Hopefully Frank Vogel and them are looking at it. I just think Vogel doesn't trust Bobo on defense and treats him like a stepchild. You know what I mean? And completely disregards him. Bobo hasn't been in since Vogel yelled at him in that Clippers game that we watched, and I pointed that out. And Vogel went off on him. I'm like, why are you yelling at him? He's not your star player turning the ball over. Why are you yelling at him? And
because that's somebody he can get away with yelling
exactly at. And so the more I think about it, I think Bobo could help out size-wise. I just don't think we're going to see it. I hope we do, but I don't think we will.